हेलो क्लास फाइव, सो वी हैव बीन स्टडिंग द चैप्टर फोर्स एंड एनर्जी. यस, चैप्टर नंबर 9. सो द लास्ट टॉपिक दैट वी स्टडी वाज इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फोर्स. यस, एंड वी आल्सो स्टडी डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ टॉपिक, लाइक वी स्टडीड अबाउट द what is force, effect of force, magnetic force, gravitational force. So we study different kind of force. Okay. हेलो क्लास फाइव, सो वी हैव बीन स्टडिंग द चैप्टर फोर्स एंड एनर्जी. यस, चैप्टर नंबर 9. सो द लास्ट टॉपिक दैट वी स्टडी वाज इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक फोर्स. यस, एंड वी आल्सो स्टडी डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ टॉपिक, लाइक वी स्टडीड अबाउट द what is force, effect of force, magnetic force, gravitational force. So we study different kind of force. Okay. So electrostatic force, as you can see on your screen, this topic we studied last time only definition, and but today we will study the effect of electrostatic force. Okay. But before we start, let's revise whatever we studied. Okay. So what is force? Force is a push or pull of an object. Yes, when you apply force, the object start moving. Yes, yes. So you need to push or you need to pull. That is actually force. So, kids, there are different effects of force. A force can change the shape of an object. Yes, this is the effect number one. It can change the shape and size of the object. A force can change the speed of an object. Yes, remember it. A force can change the speed. Yes, means if the any bicycle is riding, if you are riding a bicycle, if you apply more force on pedal, then the speed will increase. But if you will apply less pedal, then speed will decrease. Okay. So a force can change the shape of object. A force can change the speed of an object. Yes, making it faster or slower. And if we see the third effect is a force can change the direction of the object. Yes, a force can change the direction of the object. Okay, so these are the three effects. Force can change the shape of object, speed of object, and direction of the object. Okay, you know, when you play badminton, that time when you smash with a racket on shuttlecock, then what happens? It goes to another side, but maybe you can smash it into different ways, so it will go into different direction. Okay, and you know, there are different type of force. Yes, there are different type of forces, like a frictional force, normal force, magnetic force, air resistance force, spring force, gravitational force, electrical force. Electrical force is also known as electrostatic force. Okay, don't worry, we will study in detail. We will also see the effect of it. Tension force, magnetic force, so friction force. So there are different type of force. Yes, all the forces are not given in your book, only some forces are, few forces are given, but when you will go to higher classes, you will study there about all these type of forces, okay? Frictional forces, normal forces, magnetic force, oil resistance force, applied force, spring force, gravitational force, electrical force, tension force, and many. Okay? So, last time we studied a magnetic force. So, can you tell me what is magnetic force? So, you know that magnetic force is also known as magnetism. Magnetic force is also known as magnetism. So, it is a force of pushing or pulling between magnetic poles. Yes. What is magnetic force or what is magnetism? Magnetism or magnetic force is the force of pushing or pulling between magnetic poles. Yes. It applied by magnet. It applied by magnet. And it acts at a distance and cannot be seen. Yes. It acts at a distance and cannot be seen. Okay. So, you know that there are two poles, North Pole and South Pole. Yes. So, when like poles of magnet are near each other, when like poles of magnet are near each other, like pole means same pole, like a North-North Pole or South-South Pole of two magnet. So, when like poles of magnet are near each other, a repulsive force exists and the magnets move away. That's why they will repel each other, means move away, so if the force is great enough. Okay, but when the opposite force, opposite poles, when the opposite pole of magnet are near each other, means south and north, both of different poles are near to each other, then what will happen? An attractive force will exist, yes, and the magnet will come together and they will attach to each other if the force is great enough. So, the closer the object, the greater the magnetic force. The magnetic force is greatest at the poles of magnet. Remember this line, kids. Where will be the magnetic force great? The magnetic force will great at the poles of magnet. Okay. And we also studied about the gravitational force. Yes. So, gravitational force is a force that attracts all the object or masses to each other. Gravity is responsible for making Earth revolve around the Sun and the Moon around the Earth. Okay, kids, as you can see on the screen, electrostatic force. So, you know that when we move the dry comb in our hair, then through hair, then what happens? The comb get the charge, and if you bring the comb near the piece of paper, then they will attract towards it. Why? Because piece of paper have different charge and comb has now different charge. Okay, one has positive and another has negative charge. So positive and negative charge attract each other. But suppose if the piece of paper and comb both have same charge, then what will happen? They will not attract each other. Yes, they will repel each other. So positive-positive charge repel each other, negative-negative charge repel each other. But positive-negative charge attract each other. Positive charge are denoted by plus, negative charge are denoted by minus. So what is electrostatic force? The force that a charged body exert on another charged or uncharged body is called electrostatic force. Yes. So electrostatic force is defined as when two body which has different charge, then this force is applied. May be possible that both body may be charged, but different charge will attract each other. Okay, remember. So the force that a charged body exert on another charged or uncharged body is called electrostatic force. Now, kids, we will study about, we will see the effect of electrostatic force. Let's move on to the next point. Okay, let's see the example. Through example, we will find out the effect. So, example number one. When we run a piece of paper with the oil in our head, with the help of a comb, produces electrostatic force. Yes, this example I already explained. Okay, next example. Let's see the next example. balloon get attracted to another balloon when one of them are rubbed with air? Yes. Suppose you have two balloon. Rub one balloon in your hair. Then what will you do? You will suspend both balloon with the help of thread. Then what will happen? As you will leave them, they will come together. They will attract towards each other. But if you rub both balloon in your hair, then if you will hang them, suspend, then they will not come near to each other. Yes, they will move away. They will repel each other. Why? Because they got the same charge. But if you will rub only one balloon and another balloon is as usual, then both will have different charge. Because when you rub the balloon in your hair, the balloon gets the charge from your hair. So that's why the balloon becomes charged and another balloon is uncharged. So charged balloon attract uncharged balloon. And you know that what is electrostatic force, that a force that a charged body exert on another charged or uncharged body. Okay. Example number 3. When I do iron my silk or cotton cloth, keep it right in front of me, they just cling onto my body. Yes. You know, whenever you do iron, if you ever tried to do iron on silk or cotton cloth, and if you keep it right in front of you, then what will happen? They will cling to your body. Yes, they will stick to your body because they got the charge because of rubbing of iron to the cloth. And then your body is have different, your body also have charge, but both have different charge. So they will attract each other. Okay, that's why it happens. It is the effect of electrostatic force. Okay, so remember it, both objects should be either charged or uncharged, but both should have different charges. One should have positive, another should have negative, then they will attract. Okay, next example number 4. Lightning is also another example of electrostatic force. Yes, lightning is another example. You know, when our earth has different charge and the cloud has different charge, but when the positive charges of cloud meet with the negative charges of the earth, then the lightning occurs. Yes, this is the reason it happens during the rainy season. Yes, because our earth has both charge, positive and negative charge. Okay, and when the positive charge of the cloud meet with the negative charge of the earth, then lightning occurs. In 8th class you will study about detail. Okay. Don't worry. Or if you want to study how does lightning occur, you can take the book of 8th class and study the page, study the chapter. You will get the information how does lightning occur. Okay, electrostatic force, this topic is also in 8th class. Okay, so you will study in 8th class also about it. So remember these examples. Example number 1, when we run a piece of paper with the oil in our head with the help of comb, produce electrostatic force. Example number 2, balloon gets attracted to another balloon when one of them are rubbed with hair. Example number 3 is when I do iron my silk or cotton clothes and keep it right in front of me, they just cling on to my body. Example number 4, lightning is also another example of electrostatic force. So kids, I hope that electrostatic force, this topic has completely clear in your mind. Now let's study the mechanical force. Let's move on to the next point. Okay, it's mechanical force. Okay, so what is mechanical force? Actually, द फोर्स अप्लाइड बाई मशीन इज कॉल्ड मैकेनिकल फोर्स. यू कैन ऑल्सो थिंक यू नो ट्रैक्टर मोटर कार मोटर व्हीकल्स कार दे हैव इंजन्स दे आर मेड ऑफ मशीन्स. सो मशीन्स अप्लाई द मैकेनिकल फोर्स. जनरली मशीन्स अप्लाई द मैकेनिकल फोर्स बट नॉट ओनली मशीन्स देर आर वी कैन define it in a different way because whenever the machines of car tractor apply the force they push the car or you know crane help to pull any object. Yes, so force applied by machine is called mechanical force. But one more definition I have written as you can see on your screen. Mechanical force comes into play when a pull or push comes in physical contact with an object. Yes, so when does the what is mechanical force? So whenever the push or pull you know means force, when the force come in physical contact. Yes, when they are in physical contact means when if you are applying force. Yes, but you are physically in contact, that time the force which is applied is known as mechanical force. When you apply the brake, your leg is in contact with the brake, so you are pushing, so that time mechanical force you are applying. Yes, example you can see on your screen. When you open a door, your hands pushes the door, opening it. Yes, when you apply force on your by your hand on the door, then you push the door. Either you push the door or you pull the door. So what happens? What is happening? You are applying mechanical force. Yes, you are applying mechanical force. This force is known as mechanical force. So a mechanical force come into play when a pull or push come in physical contact with an object. Okay, so remember it should be in physically contact. Okay, or it is also applied by machines, you know. Now let's study a different type of force, which is buoyant force. Okay, let's move on to the next point. Okay kids, now it's time to study buoyant force. Spelling of buoyant force is BUOYANT, buoyant FORC force, or you can say buoyancy, BUOYANCY, buoyancy. You know, if you might have seen that if you try to dip the jug, plastic jug, into the water, it comes up again and again. Yes, does it happen? Yes. Why? The reason behind it is buoyant force. Yes. So, if someone dies, if someone die in the water, then what will happen? His dead body will come on the water, come on the surface of the water. Again, it will come back on the surface of the water. Why? Because of buoyant force. Yes. Buoyant force depend upon different things. Yes. It depends upon the density. Okay. So what is density? Density is actually the ratio of mass and volume. Density is the ratio of mass and volume. You know what is mass? Mass means you can say the weight in kilogram. Okay, and volume means length into breadth into height. Okay, so what is buoyant force? The force, upward force in a liquid that causes an object to float. Yes. The upward force that is applied by water, an upward force that is applied by water in upward direction is known as buoyant force. Okay, but you know, if you dip the stone into water, what will happen? It will dip, it will not come back on the surface of the earth. Why? Because in that condition, the force which is known as gravitational force is more than buoyant force. Yes, when you dip the stone into water, that time water also apply the buoyant force, means water is also applying buoyancy force. But buoyancy force on the stone is very less in comparison to gravitational force. Yes, we know that gravitational force pull towards the earth. Yes, that's why it will dip into the water. But suppose if the buoyancy force is more than the force of gravitational force, then the stone will float. Yes, in lockdown you might have seen Ramayana. In Ramayana you might have seen that the Hanuman and his team make bridge by writing the name Shri Ram on the stone, and they make the bridge and the stones started floating. Yes, you might have seen. So how is it possible? The reason behind it is buoyancy. That time, according to science, okay, maybe according to us that it is a magic, but according to science, if we talk about it, then we can say that the force is applying by water in upward direction, because buoyant force always apply in upward direction. That time the force of gravitational force is less, buoyant force is more. That's why they start floating. Yes, and one more reason is density. It also depend, buoyant force also depend upon the density of fluid and density of the object. So if the density of the object is less in comparison to the density of water, then that thing will float. If the density of the object is less than the density of water, then the object will float. But if the density of the object is more than the density of water or any liquid, then it will sink. That's why, you know, in Ramayana, the stones float. The reason behind it is density. Yes, the density of those stone is less than the density of water. That's why they start floating. Okay, that is the reason behind it. It is according to the science. Okay. Well, it also depend upon the shape of the object. Yes, length into breadth into height also matter. You know, that's why the ship float on the water. They do not sink. All the ships do not sink in the water. Okay. But if you will make a hole into the ship, it will fill up with water and it will sink. Why? Because the density will increase of the object. When the density increase, object will not float. When the density decrease, object will always float. So I hope you understood buoyancy force, or you can say buoyant force. Upward force in a liquid that causes an object to float is known as buoyant force or buoyancy. And it depends upon different factor: density of object, density of fluid, shape of object. What is density? Density is defined as mass by volume. Yes, mass means weight in kilogram. It doesn't matter what is the weight of the object. The point is volume and density. Okay, it's all depend upon the shape and density. You know, the nail, N-A-I-L, nail keel. A nail sink in the water, but ship does not sink in the water. The reason behind it is buoyancy and density. I hope you understood. It's a very easy topic. Now let's study the next topic, which is frictional force. Okay, kids. So let's study the frictional force. Frictional force is also known as a friction. Okay. So suppose you have a good bicycle. Suppose you have a bicycle. Okay. And if I say to you that ride the bicycle in soil, can you ride the bicycle in soil easily? No, you cannot. But if I say ride the bicycle on road, can you ride easily? Yes, you can ride it very fast. Yes. And as you can see in the picture, the boy are gliding on the ice. Yes, they are sliding on the ice. Okay, as you can see, the boys are sliding on the ice. How is the boy sliding? Yes. The reason behind it is the surface of the snow, the surface of the snow is smooth, but another boy, B boy, there are two boys, A boy and B boy, the another boy which is sliding on the grass, it's not easy to slide, right? Reason, it is not smooth, the surface is not smooth. So we can say that when any surface is smooth, you can easily slide on it. You know, if the surface of house marble, the marble, if you try to run on marble, it is difficult to run. You can fall, you can slip. But if you try to run on the road, you can easily run, because the road surface is not as smoother in comparison to the surface of marble. Okay. So the reason behind it is friction. Yes. Because on the smooth surface, friction is less, and on the hard surface, friction is more. Okay. Now let me give you one more example, then we will see the definition of friction. Okay. You know, when you ride a bicycle, you apply the force, you apply the brake. When you press the brake of the bicycle stop. When you, suppose you are riding the bicycle, and if you press the brake of bicycle, what will happen? The bicycle will stop. Why? Because that time a force is also working in backward direction, which is trying to pulling the bicycle backward. That's why the bicycle stops. Okay. In the same way it happens with car. Okay. You know, even when we walk, that time friction force also work. Friction force also work in backward direction. That's why we are able to walk. I can rub my hand easily. The reason behind it is friction force, because friction force is helping. And if you rub your hand for 10 minutes, then what will happen? Your both hand will become warm, because the reason is friction force generate heat. So what is friction? Friction is a force that opposes the motion of any two surface. Yes. Friction is a force that opposes the motion of two surface. Yes. It always apply in the different direction. Yes. If you are walking forward, friction will apply backward. If you are walking backward, friction will apply forward. Okay. It make us balance. Okay. And friction, so as you can see on the screen I am reading, friction is a force that is created whenever two surfaces move or try to move across each other. Yes, friction is a force that is created when two surfaces move or try to move across each other. Yes, when they try to move across each other, friction always opposes the motion or attempted motion of one surface across another surface. Yes, it always opposes the motion or attempted motion of one surface across another surface. Yes, it always apply in opposite direction. Friction is dependent on the texture of both surface. Yes, it also depends on both surface. That's why you can ride the bicycle in on the road, you cannot ride bicycle on in the soil, because the friction force in soil is more. Yes, on rough surface friction force apply more, but on smooth surface friction force apply less. Yes, that's why when you ride bicycle on the road, you can easily ride, because friction force which is working on backs of backward direction, it is less. But if you ride the bicycle on the soil, the friction force will increase. You cannot ride the bicycle because it is pulling you backward. So friction is also dependent on the amount of contact force, okay, among the contact force pushing the two surface together, okay. It's also depend upon amount of contact force pushing the two surface together. So remember this point, friction is a force that is created when two surfaces move or try to move across each other, okay. And friction is dependent on the texture of both surfaces, and friction also depend on the amount of contact force pushing the two surfaces together. I hope you understood, okay. Now let's move on to the next point. Okay, it's time to ask question from you. Question number one, what is mechanical force? Write its example. Okay, what is mechanical force? A mechanical force comes into play when a push or pull come in physical contact with an object. Yes, what is mechanical force? A mechanical force is a force which comes into play when a pull or push, when a pull or push comes in physical contact with an object. Example, when you open a door, your hands pushes the door opening it. Yes. Next question. Question number, write any two example of electrostatic force. Write any two example of electrostatic force. So you know what is electrostatic force, the force that a charged body exert on another charge or uncharged body is called electrostatic force. Okay. And example number one, lightning is the example of electrostatic force. Okay. Lightning occurs due to the when the positive charge of the cloud meet with the negative charge of the land, then lightning occur. And balloons get attracted to another balloon when one of them rubbed in the hair. Yes, when you rub the balloon in your hair and suspend both balloon with the help of thread, they will come near to the each other, they will attract each other. Okay, this is also example of electrostatic force. And if you run a comb in your hair, then take some piece of paper and bring near to the comb, they will attract towards it. Okay. And if you do iron on your silk clothes or cotton clothes, then they just cling to them. Okay. This is also the example. Okay. Next question. Question number three is, define buoyancy. Yes. What is buoyancy? An upward force applied by liquid that causes an object to float is known as buoyant force or buoyancy. Okay. So buoyancy, or you can say buoyant force, depend upon different factors like density of the object, density of the fluid, shape of the object. Okay. If the density of the object is more than the density of fluid, then the object will sink. But if the density of the object is less than the density of liquid, then the object will float. So the density should always be less. Okay. I hope you understood. And in next class we'll study something more about friction. Okay. We will see the advantage, disadvantage. Okay. We will study also about the forms of energy. Okay. So now we will meet in next class. Till then, bye bye.